Hello guys, it's noon here, Buddy is sleeping, and the fool is not. He's not. Ah, yeah, he's bored. Wolf? Very hot outside. I would love to have him with me inside, but he's a little monster. So I'm not going to show you Buddy because he's sleeping in the shade. Let's go inside. We have lots of things to throw on, definitely. We have to throw some rails here, all over the ship. Even to the bow, we have to throw some rails here. And also to the bow, there's not a single, how to say, instruction of how to do that. But I don't believe it's hard. The only point that I need to find is where to start and where to begin. Probably we're going to need a couple of rings and some rope. That's it. We'll do that together, so don't worry. So, I was saying, lots of stuff to throw on, but, oh, this was a power failure. Momentarily, but that's not good. So, what I was saying, lots of things to throw on, but before proceeding to any of the rails and adding the cannons here and attaching them with ropes and all the stuff, we have to varnish the ship. The deck is varnished. I need to varnish all the extras, but to varnish the ship I have to throw on the gun ports and some decorations that goes above the gun ports. Then I will do some masking and I will varnish it. The varnishing is going to be very easy, the masking is going to be hard because I have to mask the windows, the lanterns, of course these 10 cannons, because the cannons are gun metal, I'm not going to varnish them matte. Varnish here these rails, varnish here because here we have some windows, let's say. So we have masking. I have to mask this and then varnish, and of course I have to mask the entire rear part, just the windows. So today we're going to make the gun ports, and this we'll start with these, which are the pieces that we need for the lifeboat that goes on the side. And to be more specific, right here and right there where we have the open holes. So let me find what we need and I'll get back to you. Okay, these are the materials for these pieces. In case you're wondering why we have 75 and 76, is because 76 is a bit smaller in length. I believe there must be a purpose for that. This is not going to be hard. These are the pieces that would go and fit inside the hull. They're going to be two on each. You have to remember that this must face up and down, so we have to throw them on in the side like that. Exactly like that. Where this begins. So now I have to drill a hole of 1 millimeter in each one of them. I have what I need here. What I don't have is the 1 millimeter drill. One. All right, now let's see. This goes over here. Perfect. Let's see now how much is the length of this piece. And of course we're going to need four of them, but let me find out how much is the length. So I have it up to here. And I'm cutting right there. So this is what I need. Now, let me cut them, glue them, and I'll get back to you. Got them. The pieces here are not glued. You can see they move. I'm going to glue them in position as soon as I get them on. There's nothing difficult about that. Let me show you. Okay. You see here we have holes. So these are going over there. You just have to align them and make them to be in the correct height. That's it. And glue them in position. So, let me do that because I have to paint them, and I'll get back to you to show you the finishing result. Cut them. Let me give you a tip. To make the height correct, you just have to measure how long this is from the rail and how long in the height this is from the rail. This is 2 centimeters, this is 2.5. So you put the ship in a position that you see vertically, and you measure this height and this height, and you adjust and glue. Pretty easy. So done that, let's proceed to the gun ports. As you can see, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, don't know what this is. This is strip, it says here, and cover it. We need to make 4, so these are windows. So we have 4 different gun ports. Each gun port has a cover of 0.7 by 4 strip. These strips are the ones that we used, we were using for the deck, but these are going to be painted. Also we have these pieces here. Okay, let me cut them, clean them, and I'll get back to you. I have cut and cleaned all that we need for the gun ports. These are gun ports. These also gun ports. These must be windows, bow and stern. These are decorations, also decorations, but different. Probably for bow and stern. And these are the hinges for the gun ports. As you can see, I haven't quite cut them entirely because I need to paint them. And if I cut them, I'm probably going to lose them. So, this will be black. This, and this will be red. And all this underneath, red on top, black. But on top, we have to throw on the strips that we were using for the deck. So this will be extremely time consuming and hard. I'm not going to show you how to glue pieces of wood on the top. There's no point. You can understand that. So after I glue them, paint them, and I'm ready to throw them on, I will be talking again. This you see here, it was around 2.5 hours, maybe 3. I believe the painting, 2 colors, will be another 1.5, maybe 2, if something goes wrong. And to cover all these tiles with wood will be a day. And after that, we have to make some correctional painting. And before we attach them, you see here we have small holes. We have to open up holes for the ropes to pass. This will be interesting. I'm guessing 3 to 4 days work, the entire part. So, I'll get back to you in a moment for you when all these are painted. And this is the third day that I'm working on the gun ports, and I have them painted. To explain how I paint them, of course, with airbrush. After I glued the pieces of wood, I took some masking tape, laid it down, and painted the black first. But to paint the black, I placed the tiles next to each other like that, so this part won't be painted. After that, I turned them around, glued them on this position with a little bit of space in between, so the red will be painted also the sides. Of course, some corrections were in order, but the outcome came out pretty good. I have marked them by number, as you can see here, so I know which is which. These were painted without cutting them free from the board. Some corrections are in order, you can see at the side, but these are going to be placed on top of the gun ports, and I will do the corrections to the black after that, not right now. To tell you the truth, this are impossible to paint with paintbrush because they have tiny holes, so everything will be destroyed. So I see that I have to make a lot. Let's start by 267. 267, I have 4 tiles. They are here. They seem square, but they are not. So I have to put these on like that. Seems okay. I have to do them all exactly the same way, following this. It's not hard, it will take a lot of time, but we're not finished. After we do that, we have to drill holes. So stick around, because after I finish them, we have some more work to do. All right, everything is painted. I have made any necessary corrections, and now I have to drill holes. This is going to take a long time. I'm going to drill holes of 0.8. This one is done. And have to be very careful not to destroy everything. A power drill, not a pen drill, a power drill would be a mistake. All right, I have a long, a very long way ahead of me. So let me do that and I'll get back to you, because the next step is to start mounting things on the side of the ship. Okay guys, it's time to throw on the gun ports. Let's begin from the 267, which I have only 4. There's a reason that I have only 4. I need to place 2. One goes here and one goes here. And let's see how to do that. Of course, to do that, we need to have the glue to be able to flow through the tube. Okay. And the second one should go over here. That would be a little bit hard. Let's draw some glue here to hold it. Okay. I have 271s. Here we have them. This one goes above. First place, then glue. And the other one goes above here. I'm not going to put it right away because I have to place first the 268s, which are these. And this will be placed vertically. And the piece again on top. That's a small problem. Over here, something tells me that I will place that closer. I just have to cut them. Give me a moment. After all, this is far from the camera to see, so I'm getting closer in the next ones. Just trimmed a little bit the edges, and it's better now. Okay. Let's see now what we have next. Right here we have to place a 264. This is the 264. And above it, a 270. Let me just give it a small drop here to secure it. The problem is that I don't know if the leads, the Canon leads, are exactly the same in each row. Because here, this one is the 263. It's different. So I don't know if it's probably it's the same. Here it's 264, and from here and now 263. Let's see. And above a 270 again. Let me check it out. This was a little bit hard, but I got it. Let me show you now. We have four different leads. We have placed the two of them. So we have three different leads. We have the 263s, 4s, and 5s. So listen how it goes. We have 28 265s. So we need 14 for side. We have 28, 400, and 63s. Again, 14 per side. And we have 18, 264s. That means 9 per side. Let's go and do the easy task. 265s, the middle row, 14 up to the front. Let me remove the camera. So this row, 265s, 1. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Over here, we're going to have 267. So, middle row complete. Here is 264. The rest is 263. That goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 263s. And this is 264 again. So,
We have low row, middle row. We have left 7 of 264s. And it goes like that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These two doesn't have a cannon lead. Of course, this doesn't have two. This doesn't have a cannon lead. And two these have cannon lead, 264. So equals 7. And the two we have in the low row, 9. This is how they're going to be placed. I have written down low one from rear, from stern to bow, 1 by 264, 14, 263, 1, 264. Mid, 14, 265, 1, 267. And the top, 264, 5 pieces, 8 pieces no, 8 holes that is, and gun port holes, and 264s. So let me put them, the lower line gets this, and the upper lines gets this, as I, but I do have here, and I will follow it, because as you can see, some of them doesn't have an upper decoration. So let me do that and I'll get back to you to show you the finishing result. And done. And she's looking absolutely fantastic. Oh boy. Now, let me show you some things. The entire low, come on, focus. The entire low row has decorations of 270. That's the piece number. The 273 piece does not appear anywhere in the schematics, goes over here. The other 272 goes via here. We have the single ones, as you remember, from the other side. The 272 goes as you see here. In the top row, two without. Two have decorations. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 without decorations, one with. The low, the mid row. 1, 2, 3, 4 with decorations. 1, 2 without. 1, 2, 3, 4 with decorations. 1, 2, 3 without. 1 with decoration. And here we have a piece that I cut from above over here to make the decoration fit. So this is how the decorations are going. If you think that we are done over here, you're mistaken, because above each decoration, and of course in the appropriate place with, to the pieces without decoration, we're going to drill some holes. These holes are going to be used to pass the ropes, because if you remember, we made some holes in the cannon port leads, so we need to throw on 2 pieces of rope in each lead. Oh boy. So we have to go and drill 2 holes on each gun port. This will take a lot of time. Don't believe there's something particular about filming that. I will do some, I will talk to you, tell you about that and how we're going to do it, but it's nothing difficult, nothing special. So, as you can see, she looks fantastic. The air condition is killing me. Looks fantastic. Absolutely gorgeous. Oh boy. Wow. Wow.
No, I prefer this.
Fantastic. So guys, I began making them on Friday. Today is Monday. 4 days. 4 days. This was very time consuming without being hard. So thank you very much for watching. Don't forget the Super Thanks ability. Now that I'm without a job, I can depend on that, believe me. And I don't believe I will get a job before September or October. This is summertime. Nobody is hiring. And don't forget to take a look at the recommendations that I made for you at the Moderate Central. And I hope to see you all in our next video as well. Take care.